cut up some wood. Posts. Because I wanted to test a theory in here. But first I'm going to need to cut these to size. Got the form in here. So those are 1820. I'm going to cut them to 1820. Alright, well there they are. Two sticks the same size as those poles. Would it look better for me to just go the whole way across? And then I can sort of work something out for the top. You know what I mean? Like, if there's a thing going across the top, then there's not much so much focus on that. I can sort of build up wood over there. Or like I probably could have thought of this earlier before sticking this fucking aluminium on. I don't know, the aluminium kind of seems a little bit like excessive now. Okay, so there's a couple of things going on. First off, you'll see there that I have framed this in a different way. Now, I went and got these, they're fence palings, but I just wanted to see, and I thought, like, 1.8 meters, I'll check it out, what it looks like on the wall, and I did, and I've got a few more of them down there. I bought about 10. They come at $4.60 each, so it cost me $46. If I got 10, I believe I'd be able to line up one, so $80 would line up two. But what I'm thinking is, there's a few things I can do here. One is to leave it in this fashion, where we've got this thing happening. The second thing that I thought I could do is to actually line the wall with these. Now, I also started thinking, why have I made these into these squares? It's going to make it hard for me to put a screw in without it splitting. So instead, what I should have done is to make one this size, which would be about 80 mil, and then I could just simply drill through the middle of it. The thing is, once that door goes on, you won't see this anymore. So what's the point, right? You'll see this, and you'll see a little bit of this, and then it'll be this thing over the top of it, right? So what I was thinking is, although I've already put this metal on there, I'm thinking that it's going to come off. And so I'm going to rip off that metal. And if you check this out, right? Check it out. Just pick up some pieces here. But basically, we can then line the top of this with these pieces here. Right? I mean, I could do it the other way around, just so you get an idea, like so. So instead we're not using metal, but we're using wood, and I can, cut the woods, cut the pieces of wood to size, so that they fit in here, and this will be what covers the top section. I can use this aluminium then on the door, because, let's be honest, the door looks fucking shithouse, right? It's a door, but it's got, some characteristics. So, basically, if I have and line the wood, and I'm thinking of going horizontally with it, and I use this metal on the door, so I still have this contrast of the wood and metal stuff, it still look good like that, right? This aluminium, this metal, on the door so we can reuse it. So I think that's the option I'm going to go with, which is a little bit pain in the ass. I have to rip all that off. Now, let me show you something else. We're in the bedroom now, and yesterday I bought these damaged pieces of woods for woods. I said woods again. For $3 each, which is a fucking bargain, to be honest. So why did I do that? Well, I figured that this could be a lining for the top here. So I've cut it to size, and if you guys just sit here for a sec, I've cut it to size, and that's upside down. Basically, that just goes in like that, and it's a fucking good fit, I gotta tell you. So, imagine, if you will, the roof lined with this, and it bends, right? So it's perfect for me to just be able to fix it to those spots. Now, the only real issue that I have here is these things here, and I'm going to decide whether or not I'm going to let that be an issue. And by that I mean, I might just go straight over the top without cutting this stuff here. I might just leave it and go straight over the top, but it will mean that I might, you know, there's going to be a gap between where I put the wood, which will sit here, right? The wood will sit there, and then there'll be this little gap here. So these are the things I'm playing with, but I'm really, really fucking happy that this is going to be my roof, right? And I'm thinking that this is going to be the roof throughout, because these sheets, these things are $7. But if I can keep going and getting damaged $3 ones, that's more than half the price. And I reckon I'll need about 20 to 30. Nah, more than that. I probably need about 50. At $3, we're talking about $150 to do the roofing. And I mean, that will look sick. You know, that will look sick. And it does look sick. Alright, so I've cut those two, 1800. And I also found a piece in the back which I tried to cut, and then my table saw did that fucking thing where it goes, wants to go sideways again. But I managed to cut this piece at 20mm, which this is hardwood, and it looks kind of magnificent on sitting on the top there. So I'm going to use that as the fascia, and underneath I'm going to do these guys. So that's ready to go. So I'm going to nail this, screw this in, and then I'm going to start to cut these guys and line them up thus ways. All right, they're screwed in. How good does that look? That's halfway done. I mean, it doesn't like really look as good as I thought it might, but it still looks all right, I guess. Well, I managed to get the first one in. It's not the best, but the metal screws did go all the way in. And then the second one isn't even screwed in. It's just locked in into these grooves. So it's actually working out quite well. So this one was only done on the center too. I mean, the end too. The center, there's a screw there, but it's not actually even in. It didn't go in all the way. So with the rest of them, because that first one didn't have anything to clamp to, there's no thing here, whereas there is here. There's no metal bit there. But this one does have the metal bit. So what I'll do is I can drill into here plus here. So what I might do is I might drill into these bits first, and then I'll do the outsides. Boom! Holy shit, I'm tired. I just did three. Does that look good? It's kind of hard to tell that you're staring at a roof. That looks fucking cool. It took ages. Oh, fuck, my arms are tired. Anyway, that's three. What a job this is. This is fucking tough. Looks great though. Imagine that carpet on the sides here. I forgot to put in the foam, so I fucked it up. Like, I had to really like push that foam in for it to fit. As you can see, that one went in pretty easily. This one, not so easily. But once the wood's on top, it won't matter. I like it, and it's probably a little bit tougher to work with the damaged pieces. That's my fault. So I'm gonna continue. I've got one more that doesn't look the best, but I'm gonna try to fit that one more. If it's all going well, then I'm gonna buy some more of those. Get this in upside down. Fucking hell. It's like, come in, I walk in with it the right way, and it always ends up upside down. I'm gonna walk in it with it the wrong way next time and see what happens then. Let's see what happens. Suspect when it's a little too easy. I call this 10-minute arms. Work. Forget 5-minute abs. This is 10-minute arms. Sim Kardashian presents 10-minute arms. When you want arms, but all you got is 10 minutes. 10-minute arms by Sim Kardashian. Buy the DVD now. Arms sold separately. You ever heard someone complain so much when they're working? I have. Sim Kardashian, 10-minute arm. Oh, yeah. It's a fucking mess in here. It's working. Sim Kardashian, 10-minute arms. When you need arms. But all you've got is 10 minutes.
man, your arms are looking really good. Thanks, I use Sim Kardashian 10-minute arms. How did you do it? Sim Kardashian 10-minute arms. Fucking 10-minute arms, motherfucker. That's how. Someone's gonna come up with a fucking 9.5-minute arms and put my fucking DVD right out the window. When everything could possibly go wrong. 10-minute arms. Sim Kardashian. Get the DVD now. At no good retailer. When you want arms, but all you can dedicate is 10 minutes. What happened to you guys? When did you fucking go? Anyway, I've been talking about my 10-minute arms for ages. This is where we're at. Alright, over here, short wall, no problem, right? You have a look here. But, if you look on this side, I just squeezed that in. And, you know, for it to just go is, I think, kind of a miracle. I think probably about 4 more panels here. What do I do when I get to the end? Not too sure. I haven't really thought about it. How good's that, though, for a day's work? Alright, as for here, I've got these guys there. My phone is about to die, so I'm going to put these in. You're going to be on charge, and I'll come in back and I'll show you the result afterwards. Bam! All of that, and I can't believe I'm missing just one piece. And if I hadn't cut that up, I probably would have it. You know, there's a little bit of it over there, and a little bit over there. So awesome, right? I'm pretty fucking happy with this. And then you walk in here and it's like boom boom. It's currently 4:16. I've probably got an hour of daylight left. And then damn, if I try to crop out that bit, but look at that roof, man. It's a fucking roof, man. My head does not touch it. It's great, you know. Oh, for fuck's sake. It's trying to be elegant in here. Whoa! Stop it! It's such a big... Yeah. Cool, right? Look at this shit. Look how good that is. It's a bit woody now, but as soon as I put that aluminium door on, that face, the facade there, looks sick. I don't know. What do you think? Do you reckon it was better with the aluminium there? An impossible wooden door? Or is it nice like this? I think it looks pretty cool. You know, you come in, you walk in, and you got this, like, you know, this is just the start. And you've got these wooden floors. It's going to be a wooden roof, obviously, now. Because now that I've seen that I can do that in the bedroom, I'm definitely going to continue with that over here. I want to do the electricity and stuff, and I'm thinking that electricity is probably going to run from here. I think, you know, this will probably be where, like, if I put the solar on the roof, I'm going to run it to a battery bank here, and then it'll go through the wall for the shower, and then it'll be easily run out here. For whatever purpose, I kind of need to know what sort of gauge wiring I'm going to put in and stuff, so I'm going to do a little bit of research, and when I say that, I'm probably going to ask somebody. I do need electricity in the room, so whether that be, you know, coming here, there's going to have to be a way that I route that so that it also ends up on this side. The the incinerator toilet. I just found out it's like $7,000. I don't have that to put down on a toilet, and the other toilets are like, you know, $200, $300, $400 for a normal fucking toilet. So let's be honest, that's a big fucking difference. So I'm gonna stick with the easy shit. Excuse the pun. The cheaper shit, because I can't afford the expensive shit. My shit is not that precious, which means I'm gonna probably go composting or black water. Composting is probably better. It will cost a little bit more, but it'll cost nowhere near $7,000, so that's a relief. Again, excuse the pun. Tell me that doesn't look good. Alright, let's stop talking. We'll get that out there and try to fix this door up. Well, the rub is that this doesn't fit that way. Somehow, the aluminium is too short for the door. And, look, I don't really want to talk about it. Anyway, that's annoying because it is a waste of aluminium. I guess I could just add some to the bottom, but otherwise I can go sideways. And I was just checking how easy it is to, like, bend the alley across, and it's not that hard. But it will leave a little bit of a bow if I don't do it right. So I need to sort of work at it. Anyway, so how good does it look? Alright, I've cleaned up some of this. I'm not sure how far I want to go in terms of, like, really fixing this door up. Maybe I might do this top bit here. All I really need to do is to get at that with the grinder. I don't really want to do that at the MDF, but, you know, here we are doing shit that we don't want to do. I've got the silicon out. Now I'm going to silicon in these bits and seal this door properly. Then I'm going to paint it. I was in Bunnings for ages looking at vinyl and all this shit, and my head got done in, and I just thought, fuck, I just want to get this out of the way. So I'm going to paint it. Now, I understand that wood, you know, before any of you get at me and go, oh, wood expands and fucking contracts and lick my balls, man, I don't give a shit. This is how it's gone on. If it expands and contracts, so be it. I'll take them off, put another one back on, so what? I got another one of these guys. They haven't restocked their stock, obviously, but this piece was there yesterday when I bought all the other pieces. It's a little bit damaged, that's why I left it. It's damaged there, but I'm going to put that bit towards the back and that way. And then you won't even notice it. So, yeah, I don't want to hear any stories about how wood expands and shit and whatever. You know, look how good that looks, and then just shut the hell up, right? Alright, so I'm going to seal this, and then I'm going to find some place to paint it. It may be that I just lay it down over here with a... I've got these. So I'll put them on the floor, and I might just paint it in here because it's raining outside. I don't have much time today. In about an hour and a half, I got to go. And, well, that song that you kind of heard me start writing turned into a full-blown song. And I thought for once in my life I'd get someone else to mix it and master it and see how it goes. Even though I think I've done a pretty good job myself. But if he does a good job, this guy, then I might give him more of my work. And just give, you know, my music a level, you know, that's constant. At least for an album. So with this song, it'll be three songs on the album. I'm going to probably step up my game a little bit on writing music. So let's get to work. Believe my eyes. All I see is sheep. I'm awake and I stand here and count them as they.
They follow and obey. In this darkness, they can't see the light of day.
If you were ever wondering, you can cut foam with a circular saw. It's sick. It really is very good. And this is the result I've cut from a big piece. I actually used one piece to do both sides, and I left one piece whole. That piece sitting over there in its whole format. And the other ones I just had to cut. There it is. So I've cut two of those out of one piece, one big piece, and I've actually got 800 and something left. I need 780 for those pieces, which means I can get three of those pieces out of one. Now, that means one, two, and I think it's just going to be one more. Yeah, pretty much. And I might use one of the ones that are fucked to do the last bit. But that goes in real easy because the bend, you know, the bend was the hardest bit. And since I don't have to bend it on that one, it's really easy. So, yeah, cool. I could get technical and try to do this, but no. So there you have it. There's some that I need to get back in there and figure out. Maybe use a bigger drill bit. Dr. Drill bit. How good's that? I make a couple of holes in here where the circles are for the ventilation. And then I could even stick those ventilator things back on, the lids. My neighbor. Yeah, how good's this? Wood cabin, baby! Log cabin, baby!
So here we have a water-based prep pouring one. It's a primer sealer undercoat. Before I do that on this side, I am going to fill this bit with that. So I'm going to do that now, and then I'm going to do this on the top and on this side here. That was done yesterday and it's dry now. It still feels a little tacky, but yeah, let's see how the primer goes. Okay, so that's been sealed. Something that I've learned today is the primer does not like that roof and gutter sealer. So because it's on the edge that I put it on the edge there, it doesn't fucking like it. So just a little heads up. That's the thing. Anyway, I'm gonna let that do its thing. Thing says blah 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 blah. So I'm gonna just fucking do it. That's this chalkboard paint. I'm gonna probably just do one side. And the other side can be something else, I guess. If I feel like it, I might flip it over and do the other side as well. Apparently, after I've applied two coats, I get chalk and rub it down vertically. And then I get the chalk and I rub it down that way. And then after I'm done, I wipe it off. And then it's ready to be used as a chalkboard. So that's what it says. Anyway, so first off, I made it. It's a fucking shitty door, let's be honest, but... It really fucking hates the gutter sealer stuff. But I figure if I apply enough paint on there, it'll eventually, like, stick, right? So there, that's the second coat on the door there. And it is, it's dry. So I might, apparently you got to rub chalk on it. I went and got chalk. You won't rub chalk. Look, it really doesn't want to fucking, it doesn't want to stick to this stuff, but I'm going to keep going. I'm going to keep trying until it does. So apparently you rub chalk on it now and it's ready to go. You rub chalk on it that way, that way, that way, and then you rub chalk on it that way, and then you rub the chalk off, and apparently it will go. So anyway, if you have a look at this, right, you look at that black against the wood there, and I reckon that's a good contrast. The idea was that, yeah, maybe it comes down to there or something. And that's that is there, and then essentially you would build, like, you'd have the wood going up there, or you wouldn't even need to have wood at the back, right? You just have wood on the side there, the side of this, and on the bottom. A couple of different styles. So I reckon that could work quite well. So if it was there, that would be the shelf, and then I would still be able to open this window. Yeah. For ventilation. Or you just close that window off. I would rather it open though. Also, I could just have the shelf going like that. Right, so in that case, I could put it at any height, and I'll have that as the sort of thing that holds it. I'm going to flip this door over, and I'm going to paint the other side, so that both sides are chalkboard paint. I've got a lot of chalkboard paint. Okay, I'm going to prime and paint it here because I need the space. I need those table horses to start cutting shelves up. So it's just going to lean against there, and I'm going to do it there for the next couple of days. So that's the idea there. I put that there, and then the wood goes on top, and then I can screw it into there and there. And it's just going to come out a little bit. It's not going to come out a huge deal, and that'll be the seat. So I think I'll get some 12 mil ply. And I think it's 12 mil or 6 mil, I don't know. And so basically it'll sit on top of there, come out to here, there, and that should be enough for a nice tush. So all right, let's make some wood cut. I've probably got a piece of wood that's roughly around that size, and then I'll just fashion it. How about we use some reclaimed bus seat to make the seat there? Now, this is already round here, which is nice. So if I measure out and cut what I need, that can be the outside edge. And I'm pretty sure that that's going to be there. So I'm just going to measure it again. I think it was 280 by 280 or something. I'll measure it up and then I'll put that in. Freehand. So that's a freehand drawing of where these spots are. Remember again, Sim's method is measure nonce and cut thrice. So here's the first cut. There she is. Let's go see if this fits. Not bad. Not bad. Get rid of more of this. Get it closer to the edge. Is that right? If I do that line there, we'll be good. Close enough or no? Nah? That'll do. So that's the idea of that. All right, this is the old one. And this is the new one. Oh, it's fucking even better. Yeah, I like it. I could even bring it out here without suffering too much loss right out to here. And then I could just feel that later. How good's that?
Believe in all the